So we have discussed the roots of quadratic equation is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So now we will discuss about sum of the roots and product of the roots. So when we take a quadratic equation, we know that we will get at most two roots. So let us take the roots are alpha and beta. So let alpha and beta, I am taking Greek letters alpha and beta, are the roots of ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Let the roots are alpha, beta of quadratic equation. So just now in the previous class we discussed the value of x is by using formula we can find out minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So this is the formula. That means x value will get two values. One is minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, and another one is minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So for those two values I am taking as alpha. So one of the root alpha is minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, and another root beta is minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So these are the roots alpha and beta. Now I'll take sum of the roots alpha plus beta. So let us check what is the value of alpha plus beta. So what is alpha here? Minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a plus minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So the LCM of these two fractions are 2a, and in the numerator part I will get minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac. So anyway, this is plus square root of b square minus 4ac, and this is minus square root of b square minus 4ac, and these two terms will get cancelled. So that is equals to alpha plus beta equals to minus 2b by 2a. So if 2 and 2 gets cancelled, we will get minus b by a. So when the roots are alpha and beta, alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. So sum of the roots equals to minus b by a. That is nothing but minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. That is the result for sum of the roots of quadratic equation. And this is about sum of the roots. Alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. And next, let us take the product of the roots alpha and beta. So I am taking alpha into beta. Alpha into beta. So alpha into beta means I'll get minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a into minus b minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Now observe here, the numerator is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So we know the formula for a plus b into a minus b, that equals to a square minus b square. So this is equals to minus b whole square minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole square by 4a square. So if we solve this, minus b whole square means alpha into beta equals to b square, and here the square root and square will get cancelled, and the remaining part is b square minus 4ac by, and in the denominator part we have already, that is 4a square, that equals to b square minus b square plus 4ac by 4a square. So b square and b square gets cancelled, and the remaining part is 4ac by 4a square, and 4a, 4a gets cancelled, it is c by a. So actually what is c in the quadratic equation, which is a constant term? So that equals to constant by coefficient of x square. So from these two results, we can conclude that when alpha, beta are the roots of quadratic equations, then sum of the roots alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a, and product of the roots alpha into beta equals to c by a. So what we have learned here, sum of the roots alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a, and product of the roots alpha into beta equals to c by a. So these two results we learned in this a. Now, with the help of sum of zeros and product of zeros, we can find the quadratic equation when the roots are given. So, till now we learned, if a quadratic equation is given, then we can find the roots of quadratic equation by using factorization method and by using formula method. So now if we have the roots of quadratic equation, then how can we find the quadratic equation? That we will learn now. Okay, so let us take ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0 is quadratic equation, whose roots are alpha and beta. Right. So if I divide the quadratic equation by a, I'll get this. Yes or no? So I'll divide the whole equation by a. So ax square by a means a gets cancelled, and here bx by a plus c by a equals to 0. That means x square plus x into b by a plus c by a equals to 0. So x square minus x into minus b by a I can write. Why? Because I have the value of minus b by a as alpha plus beta plus c by a equals to 0. So x square minus x into minus b by a is nothing but alpha plus beta plus c by a is nothing but alpha beta equals to 0. So the given quadratic equation, I can write x square minus x into sum of the roots plus product of the roots equals to 0. So we can find the roots of a quadratic equation by using formula. With the help of that, we can find the sum of roots and product of roots. So which is equals to alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a, and alpha into beta equals to c by a. With the help of these two, when the roots are given, we can find the quadratic equation by using this formula. That is nothing but x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta equals to 0. Here alpha plus beta is nothing but sum of the roots, and alpha into beta equals to product of the roots. So let us discuss some examples, some questions based on these concepts. Yes. So we can find roots to quadratic equation. Now my question is, find sum and product of roots of x square plus 7x plus 12 equals to 0. So this is my question. So without finding, yes, of course we can find the sum and product of the roots by finding the roots, and we can add those two and we can multiply those two, we'll get the sum and product. But without doing without finding the roots, we can find sum of the roots and product of the roots. So here, the compare the coefficients with the standard form of quadratic equation, we'll get a equals to 1 and b equals to 6 and c equals to 12. Let the roots are alpha plus alpha and beta. So alpha plus beta equals to, our formula is minus b by a. So what is this? B is minus 7 and a is 1, which is equals to minus 7. And alpha into beta equals to c by a. So c is nothing but 12 and a is 1. That equals to 12. So let us check whether this is true or not by finding the roots. So we know how to factorize this quadratic equation by splitting this middle term. So x square plus 4x plus 3x plus 12 equals to 0. So if I take x common, I'll get x plus 4, x into x plus 4. If I take 3 common, 3 into x plus 4 equals to 0. So x plus 4 into x plus 3 equals to 0. That means x plus 4 equals to 0, or x plus 3 equals to 0, x equals to minus 4 or minus 3. So these are the roots. If we consider alpha as minus 4, beta as minus 3, what is the value of alpha plus beta? Minus 4 and minus 3, which is nothing but minus 7. And product of the roots, alpha into beta, that is minus 4 into minus 3, 4 into 3, 12. That means by using these two, without finding the roots by using factorization or formula, we can find sum of the roots and product of the roots. And next example, if the roots are given, if the roots are given, how to find the quadratic equation? So my question, find quadratic equation whose roots are 3 and 1. So that means we have the roots 3 and 1. So let alpha equals to 3 and beta equals to 1. So now find the sum of the roots, that is alpha plus beta equals to 3 plus 1, that equals to 4, and alpha into beta equals to 3 into 1, that equals to 3. So already I discussed the formula when the roots are given. If alpha beta are roots, then quadratic equation is x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta equals to 0. So if the roots are alpha and beta, then the quadratic equation is x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta equals to 0. Right. So here we got the values of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So let us substitute in that formula. So our required quadratic equation, is x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta equals to 0. So x square minus x into alpha plus beta equals to how much? 4. Plus alpha beta how much? 3 equals to 0. That is x square minus 4x plus 3 equals to 0. This is the quadratic equation whose roots are 3 and 1. And one more example. Here we have directly the roots are 3 and 1. Then if we have the if we have sum of the roots and product of the roots, directly we can substitute in this formula. Like we can find the questions like find the quadratic equation whose sum of the roots is 5 and product of the roots is 10. Just if you get this type of questions, there is no need to discuss anything. Directly we can substitute in this formula, because already he gave that sum of the roots means alpha plus beta equals to 5 and product of the roots, that is 10, means alpha into beta equals to 10. So required quadratic equation is x square minus x into alpha plus beta is 5 plus alpha beta is 10 equals to 0. That means x square minus 5x plus 10 equals to 0. So in this topic we learn if ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0 is a quadratic equation whose roots are alpha and beta, then the sum of the roots alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. That is nothing but minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, and the product of the roots alpha beta equals to c by a. That is nothing but constant term by coefficient of x square. And we can find the quadratic equation when the roots are given, alpha beta are the roots, by using the formula x square minus x into alpha plus alpha beta equals to 0. Of course, by using the same formula, we can find out when the sum of the roots and the product of the roots given.